Welcome back, everybody. Here to your coverage from the TI4 EU Hub, doing the grand final of the Chinese qualifier. I am Toby One, joined by Luminous here for game number two, man. LGD, confident start.
Yeah.
Easy way to put it.
I think CIS has really drafted themselves in the corner with the Lifesaver second pick. You were talking about how they're drafting what they're comfortable to them, but it seems like what they're comfortable to them might not be what is the best. And LGD are saying, hey, when I have first pick, we'll take the Invoker. When we don't have first pick, we're banning it out. In their eyes, it's still a great hero.
That's going to be the best hero in the game, the Invoker with the Batrider.
Sure. I agree with these two first two ban. Not so much the Lycan and the Sand King. Have we ever even seen Lycan do anything?
No. Not at all.
Yeah.
Most of the times we see a Lycan being picked up, it's a Lycan where it's like, oh, is he ever going to get to his Necro book? Like, what does he need to get himself like halfway there? It's we haven't seen a lot of him yet. I'm interested to see how CIS set the tone here with the first pick. Like, do they try and be the ones who... okay, no, they don't. I was wondering if they're going to be like the ones saying, okay, this is going to be our first call. This is going to be at least a glimpse into how our game style is going to be. But Nation Apparition could really just be anything from CIS.
It's a hero that Chinese really favor drafting first anyways. Mm. So they will.
This could just be our Naga Siren game.
It could.
From CIS. Like, get a little bit of Glory Ball and just control, split push, and that's all. That seems to be their major strength, but... it's also something which LGD can easily exploit.
Something they could also lead themselves to opening of an anti-mage pick. You just draft yourself with a very powerful defensive tri lane. Like, you can't come at us because I have chilling touch from AA, and then we're going to just farm up our anti-mage and just go for the late game plan. That could be the game plan from CIS, but obviously LGD, they have a lot of tricks up their sleeve as well. I want to really see a good push track coming out from LGD.
That'd be nice. Where's our Pugna, man? Get a Pugna, get yourself a Prophet.
They just
breach
Pugna.
The high ground.
Yeah, they used Pugna last time when on their push strat.
Yeah.
So, I think opening with like Pugna Chen right now would be pretty bad because it gives LGD a lot of, or seriously, I mean, CIS a lot of room to actually kind of maneuver around that draft.
Yeah, it also lets you know exactly what LGD is going to be doing. Like, if you can do it a little bit more subtly, that'll be nice. But they pick up a Lich, so it's lane control
LGD's
for now.
Turn to pick.
But they could also be looking for their own team fight kind of combinations. Lich.
Just do it, man. Lich tree.
Lich, no.
Protect your towers.
Don't do that, LGD. Don't listen to Lumi.
No, man.
He's leading you up the garden path, man.
No, no. The thing is, if you're losing, right? If you're losing, you could protect your towers. If you're winning, Chain Frost Overgrowth. Not too bad, man.
True, but then they could pick up something like a Darkseer and actually be a little bit more offensive.
You could put Darkseer in that too. Lich tree support.
I suppose you're right. You could do that. But they're actually going to pick up something different. A Timbersaw pickup. We don't see this guy much anymore. Ever since everyone got a little bit frustrated with Nyx Assassin or with just offlaners in general.
I think he's a great hero. Even though we haven't seen any strength hero being picked up, if you're trying to zone out AA, zone out Timbersaw level 1, yeah, fine. You could do that. You hit him a couple times. You know, get him back low. Level 4 or 5, he could come in and straight up kill you. Especially Lich gives you a Nova. I imagine we're going to see... there's a possibility of a dueling top or dueling bottom in this case since you're Darn Dire. This could be actually fairly difficult for CIS to deal with in the safe lane.
See, I'd be more worried right now the fact you revealed Timbersaw so early that, like, Doombringer or Krobulus, like, these style of heroes, the silence heroes that can just control Timbersaw, are then picked up. The Nyx Assassin for me is still flagging up insanely high as a hero to select.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm a little bit more concerned. You're not going to be banning a Timbersaw in this. You could have kept it more secret. I know that the current trend is to show every single offlaner in the first set because you don't want to reveal off your mid solo and you don't want to reveal off your major carry.
Here's the thing, though.
Two things you keep secret to the second stage.
Timber could be mid.
Could.
Yeah.
Chances low, but could.
You could run an offensive tri-lane and have Timber versus Clock if you want. 10 seconds. So yeah, we know that he's going to be a core, but does it really say what lane he is in? Or is it going to be a Lich Timber dual offlane?
You're right, they could mix it up.
Yeah.
If we go with history, though,
it'll
be the offlane.
It'll be very standard offlane, but you know, just throwing the possibilities out there.
Just like I threw out the possibility of Yasha, and I was so
I do want to say that you brought up a great point about how when you pick up Timbersaw, it really leads to CIS picking up a couple of silencing or even mono burning hero. But I feel like Timbersaw, when he's picked, he's meant to be a lane dominator. And really, what heroes out there picks up a silence in lane? Bloodseeker comes to mind, but Bloodseeker's not really a hero.
Yeah.
Skywrath Mage is a hero that picks up Silence early, but we don't see Skywrath Mage is picked at all in
you
the Chinese
You could always try the Silencer himself, but I haven't seen it being played that efficiently in Southeast Asia or China so far.
I think CIS ran it in the finals, I believe.
Yeah.
On their last game, actually.
Actually, did they run it?
Yeah, they lost. They ran a tri-lane Silencer with max Curse of Silence.
Oh, yeah, that was the one which had the two braces and the yoga club, right?
Yeah, yeah, that was the game.
Oh, God. Yeah.
It was not a good game.
I'm just feeling dirty thinking about that. Mirana,
Radiant
pick up from LGD. So they're still very flexible in their lanes.
They're hiding the lanes so well. Like, I have no clue what they're doing.
No.
Here comes Sitobi with his 19 variation of laning stage.
Welcome to the... Yeah. Oh, behind curtain number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 as options.
Especially coming from a Chinese scene, Mirana has played like a support half the time there.
Yeah.
So we don't even know.
And that's mainly Ayo's fault for doing that too, because he's like the primary one that does that.
He doesn't even do that well. Like every time he just... He shoots arrow and he misses arrow. This is no Sing Sing. I have not seen him hit arrows often.
It's a little harsh.
I mean, I'm just seeing how it is.
Bane.
Okay, we're going to see a Mirana core. That gives it away.
Yeah, but Mirana core where, though? Do you want to see this lane go aggro with a Lich or Bane as well as Mirana? Or do you actually want to try and do the dual lanes? Welcome to your 5 million options. Because we saw Lich as well as Anti-Mage run in the middle lane earlier today. Like, they actually ran a dual lane mid, and that was actually run by, that was during the CIS versus Dreamtime game, and I actually cannot recall which of them did that.
It all blurred together, that 4 hours. Remaining.
Yeah, I think it was Dreamtime, man. I think it was Dreamtime. I knew as Waga was casting and be sitting there going, yeah, that's a strat developed in Scorn there.
I actually think that going mid against a Puck is fairly decent, because Puck normally is like, I could be the Juke Master. I dodge, I orb, and all that stuff. But when there's a freaking Bane sleep coming on you, there's no dodging that.
But when you got Train Protector Armor now to protect you, you should be okay.
That's true. At the same time, if you look at CIS, no damage. This is 4 Protect 1. And playing 4 Protect 1 against Fiend's Grip, I don't know. Not so. Also, Treant, obviously, it protects your lane, but that's another hero that Timbersaw says, yes. That's a free kill, or not a free kill, but you know, you get what I mean. Like it's very advantage for Timbersaw to play against Train Ferals.
Yep.
Like Locke, like Timber, or like Treant.
I'm just getting sick of Tree, man. There's too much Tree.
Hug the tree.
I don't need to hug the tree.
Or cut it down.
I say you get a splinter. Pacifist, man.
Timbersaw, he's gonna cut it down the trees.
It's true. He definitely is not like a person that signs the Greenpeace newsletter.
No.
Trees are not his friend. I want to see the last pick up from LGD because I want to know these lanes. It should be a mid-solar, but it may not be. I just want to know what it's going to be from LGD. Because what I want to actually really see them do is just Radiant run the dual lane off lane with Bane Mirana and then run Lich plus one in the mid lane up against the Puck and leave the Timber on the top lane, because I think Timber should be fine up against the Clockwork off lane. And with a Tree and Ancient Apparition, unless you really want to get over aggressive, you can't do that against the Timbersaw. Leech Seed as well as a Cold Feet aren't going to control the Timbersaw.
Yeah, I actually think that the Timber off lane is slightly better, because like you said, they obviously will not kill Timbersaw. Mirana and Bane actually have kill potential on Clockwork. Whereas I think if Timber versus Clockwork, it's just kind of you hit me, I hit you back, that kind of situation.
Problem is then though, LGD could do something which CIS enjoy, and that's give CIS space to breathe on their safe lane.
Yeah, that's the other concern. And CIS really needs their core carry to actually win, and win hard on that lane.
Yeah, that's the reason why the Morphling was banned out. Black said it time and time again. In this game, this is almost one of these games where I would think Black would be considering the Anti-Mage. And the primary reason I say that is because mana burn up against most of these heroes, if he can actually jump in there and get the mana style off, Bane's going to have a hard time detecting which one is real straight away, and by that point, Timbersaw could be bone dry.
If you get Timbersaw low and give him a huge mana void, that is insane.
Yep.
But there's also Lich Armor to be considered. Melee carry against Lich Armor, your damage is going to be cut sizably due to the armor, obviously, and then your attack's going to be slowed.
Well, what would be your other option? Because I haven't seen him play Drow Ranger anytime recently, and with a Storm Spirit pickup, I highly doubt he will be playing that anymore, because that Storm's going to be right on top of him. I'm thinking about other heroes which can dish out DPS from range, but also can bring in another Silence. So any kind of like, are there any Orchid heroes or heroes which could rush into a Scythe device? Actually, the Doombringer is still available here, but that still brings up the same problem.
Yeah, Doom against Timbersaw, not where you want to be.
No.
I mean, I'm thinking about back to Gyrocopter, because he's the only hero that comes to mind that have enough AoE and damage.
The problem is, though, it's going to take so long to bring that Gyro online that both, like, it's too easy to catch out the Gyro.
Yeah. I don't know. Well, they have 10 seconds to think about it, because we are winding down from CIS for the last pickup.
Not a lot of time, man. And this isn't something which I think they were really hoping to be in. And they go for the Wraith King.
No.
I'm...
No.
I'm... This has to be aggro tri-lane or else bust. That's all I'm saying, man.
It is going to be aggro tri-lane. Black is playing the puck.
Wait, what?
Are they doing the Swaparino is the question.
Watch them closely. No, there's null talisman.
Buying items.
Yeah, no,
Black is playing mid.
Yep.
Prepare for. All right.
And Flame's going to be the Wraith King.
Well, I mean, he played mid last game too, so. Because he was on the OD.
Yeah. But they've got to go aggro try with this. I also love this from LTD. They were doing this during the winner's bracket final matchup, where they give a TP scroll to DDC. And he comes down very early on to plant down these wards. Gets himself prepared, so then CIS have no idea what's going on. He blocks the pull point, but I'm surprised that LGD aren't thinking, a top lane aggro tri lane is more likely. Because for me, the second that Wraith King's picked up, that's it. That's where I'd flag it.
Well, the thing is, the Chinese they like to farm their safe lane Wraith Kings. It's done like in half the game, so it's. I mean, coming from the Western standpoint, yeah, I completely agree with you. You need to aggro try, but the Chinese do things a little differently. Seconds to battle. And I think it's perhaps a little bit more inferior, but, you know, that's how they do it.
Remember, CIS have that European influence. They have the German.
The thing is, they also LGD spotted, or LGD spots them.
And they're moving, well, they're considering, they will move the Lich up. You'll just take a creep off the offlane. This means now LGD get the favorable lanes. They get the Timber up against the Clockwork. It'll be Puck versus the Storm Spirit, which for me, I still back on the Storm Spirit. Once he has the Orchid up and running, before then, it's a little bit tighter as far as who can win that lane. But considering CIS is rotating heroes, actually, they can control the Storm Spirit quite nicely in the early stages. They just can't do anything about like the Marana or the Timbersaw. It's like the mid lane's the only lane they can gank out. Rabbit may be having a real rough time in the early stages.
In terms of the mid lane, the 1v1 matchup should favor Black at this point because he has more of a favorable block. And I think, you know, obviously Storm does have the 5 base armor, but Black has, you know, better range.
Haste through movement. That was never going to work with the Observer Ward also watching.
That's fine, though. Spot. Like, Black just got the entire first wave.
Wait, where's the arrow? He hasn't actually leveled it yet. Marana actually still doesn't have a single point up in experience.
He needs to be careful about reserving leap.
Oh, this
and
could
where's
be
that
it.
Leap?
There's the leap. It's leveled back in range of the tower. Demon's haste rune still keeps going, though. But now Nightmare as well as arrow combo cannot do anything here.
I mean,
because they don't have it.
That's fine. Like, you're not going to kill this lane. Even, like, 2v1 situation, you're really not going to kill this lane. 2v3 situation, excuse me. So I think getting leap is fine. I might even level up leap.
Actually, why is then like, okay, so DDC's here on the bottom lane. So it's like LGD are accepting the fact they can't kill it. So they just try and leech out as much experience and last hits as possible. And then make sure they win heavily the bottom lane. So Timbersaw's going to harass out the Clockwork. But then again, they're both not getting some good quick levels.
They're actually going to go on Lin again.
He's got leap back off cooldown.
Nice Inflame canceling his animation. He casted it, stopped it, and went back to last hitting.
That's a big creep wave coming on bottom lane. No. Do you actually feel like this lane is favorable now? Because June's still going to out-level a Timbersaw here. That's my only concern by having the Lich down here.
I mean, Lich is, you know, it takes your mana, or not mana, your experience as well. So.
Yeah. But it's only when you can also hold the creep wave back because the experience gets split now.
I think what LG is looking to do is get this Lich up to level 3 or maybe level 4. And have him rotate top. Because suddenly a level 2 Nova Frostblast hits a ton harder. And at that point, Yao should be a level 3 himself. And he should be just fine in terms of a 1v1ing against a Jun. And we'll see whether they're going to make that rotation. Level 3 on
they're
DDC.
Right on the back of Lin. DD had the Nightmare up in Flame. If that Hellfire Blast went, then Lin would probably be dead right now.
He
could have
leapt
over
it.
The tree line.
Yeah, he could have leapt it, so he'd be fine. And yeah, they are making that rotation. Meanwhile, on the mid lane here, it's going to be Invisgang coming in from AA. That is spotted out, but the courier has no fear and is running right into the AA. Chilling touch. Two hits. Easy. Well, that was delivering the courier.
That's really cruel, man. That's really, really cruel.
I mean, here's the thing.
But can he live through this? If they get a Frost Blast off on him, Murano was looking to rotate down, but he can't find a line to even throw an arrow out. So LGD have now just rotated their mid hero off to try and get that collateral kill for losing the courier.
But
and
instead,
all they've done is give space to Black. But yeah, up on top lane, the arrow does hit on demons. And maybe there isn't enough DPS. Lich is coming in. Inflame with the stun. And Lich cannot actually reach him. So he crossbars over on one. But Bane, he can reach him with the basic attack. DD, one last hit. He does get caught inside the cold feet. He'll go down that last attack out from the Ancient Apparition. But now they've also lost the Wraith King. Arrow to connect. And it's a 3-for-1 trade after they just won the bottle advantage in the mid lane.
I mean, the bottle advantage is still going to be huge, but that just means that Black is going to do... he has to do much, much more to compensate for that Trilane losing. Trilane versus Trilane situation is where Puck really likes it, because he's going to get level 6 very quickly. You could jump top and use that burst of nuke, burst that control from the Dream Coral, and just get three kills for your team. But we'll see whether he'll be able to do just that.
And Black, he's being so over-aggressive here on Rabbit. He shouldn't be able to get the kill. Even with that last attack, they have a 13 life points on the Storm Spirit. But he's definitely pushing Rabbit to the limit because he's got no bottle. So he just wants to zone him out. And then also grabs a DD rune from the top. It couldn't get any better for Black in this game. He's 24 for 10 over a 13-2 Storm Spirit. And he's really just searching for that orb into a DD one hit onto Rabbit to get the kill.
You can see how important it is to constantly pay attention in the mid lane, because one slip up means you lose the bottle. Because that Invis rune was picked up right under that Observer, right? Like, you should have seen AA coming in Invis. Mm-hmm. But the bottle still came regardless. But it looks like they're going to make another go. It's going to be a nightmare. Arrow's going to come in, but quick take of the sleep from AO. Very nicely done.
Yeah, which means the arrow flies between the two of them. Demons trying to harass DDC back. Throw the Hellfire Blast over towards DD. He does have two points Brain Sap, so he should be able to get a lot more of these life points back again. And if they go under the tower, Inflame can find himself in a lot of trouble. Nightmare to start with, and he will get the Hellfire Blast to get the kill. The arrow a little bit off target, but Rabbit's coming towards the top lane. He's managed to get himself a kill on the Ancient Apparition while Inflame. There's no leap available. He does have three stick charges. He's going to try and cut him off with the pass. There's extra help coming in from the Tree and Protection. It's a little bit too far away. And Inflame just keeps running. Black is also moving up. Dream Call's available. And maybe Lin has overcommitted himself now. Hellfire Blast from Inflame. He is waiting because the Dream Call was able to trigger. With the Rift, it's not enough to kill off Lin until now with a follow-up attack. But it's the Wraith King is for a Murano and that Courier. Man, that's going in deep to deliver that bottle over towards Rabbit. They could have lost it all over again. But Demons will go down because of this. The extra mana coming in at the right time. And the rest of LGD, I think they should be very, very happy that was as even as it was.
Yeah, I mean, at the same time, you're not really sure who came out ahead, because on one side you have, obviously, the core of you losing the Wraith King. On the other side, Black is just being able to soak up that experience. I say that, he's only been involved in that one kill. Meanwhile, obviously, Rabbit on his rotating storm got two assists out of that. Who was really the big winner? Who actually picked up the kills? I think it was the supports from both teams.
You got three kills over on the Bane, two kills on the Wraith King, and then a 1-1-1-1 on Lich, Clock, Murana, AA.
I guess if you're Bane, you're really happy, but Bane's also dying quite a bit. Bane, though, he actually reveals himself. Haste Rune's going to get picked up by Inflame, and that means that Legit, DD, get out of there.
He's checking the corners to see if there's a TP out of that one. Timbersaw could probably come in here and help him, because there's still Nightmare and Brain Sap available in a moment. The Rocket coming in from Clockwork, and Yao is right behind him. And Inflame will break off the chase. But this is a lot of heroes now for CIS. Like, Black was also coming in, and he TP'd all the way back to base now. So he's off the lane for a good 20 seconds, while Murana free farms up on top lane, and Lich is actually soaking up the experience in mid. He's almost got his level 6 available.
I think at getting level 6 is where the turning point of the game comes in, because you get access into Chain Frost, you get access into Chakram. And that's the burst damage that LGD really need to clean up these heroes. Sure, you have Wraith King Reincarnation, but I feel like LGD has enough burst to actually kill him twice, and fairly easily at that.
Mm-hmm. And I'm still wondering when this Clockwork is going to have some kind of impact. Because June, like, correct me if I'm wrong, but he hasn't moved off that bottom lane yet.
Yeah.
Like, there's been no rotation. You have a level 7 Clockwork.
He'll move now, I guess.
Yeah, he's coming up towards Lin on the top lane. But Lin also is a hero which is very difficult to kill off. Like, with 7-1 charges and the leap ability, Clockwork can't fully control her.
Yeah, you basically need to walk up to her, force her to leap, and then hope to chase. Or else you're not going to get the kill. And in fact, I don't think he's even going for it. Probably he's going to smoke up and just go find a support in the jungle, because he can solo kill supports quite easily.
Oh, the second he comes there, he's going to not find a support. He'll find Rabbit instead, because Rabbit's trying to stack and farm. Again, that like LGD are doing a really good job right now of getting levels into these support heroes. Everyone has going to have level 6 in the next 30 seconds. As long as Bane doesn't get zoned. Oh, actually, a minute for Bane. If he doesn't get zoned out completely.
They could easily just drop the coil and just go for him under the tower.
Inflame Man? Sorry. Sorry. When I see a Hellfire Blast and he walks in melee range of the Timbersaw, I don't see that really ending well. Even with demons coming in from the side, ooh, they're looking for a Hawkshot. Well off target, though. Because he moved himself in line with the Dinosaur Creep Wave, so there was only one choice for the Hookshot. It was to throw it out left and just hope Timbersaw would stay there.
Yeah, and he went right. Meanwhile, we're going to see a smoke coming out from the top for LGD. They're thinking about going mid. The problem is, how do you actually control the puck? You need the Nightmare to actually start things off. And DD, he's aggressively looking for it. But
at this point, I think the only thing they were hoping for was the fact that Black would get over-aggressive on the Bane.
Yeah.
Because if that happened, like if he threw Orb as well as Phase Shift, then Storm would just jump.
They're running up the hill here. Smoke breaks, but where they're actually going for is a question. They're now being scouted out by Observer Wards.
Yep, the one that's sitting a little bit deeper inside the lane.
You know, both teams are really failing their ganks. I think this actually favors LGD because they do have better cores, I want to say. And again, we haven't really discussed this much because CIS finished their draft so quickly with the Rave King last pick.
Yeah.
Essentially playing 4 Protect 1 with the Rave King that... I mean, he's okay with a 2-2 score, but I really think he needs like a 5-minute Midas into like an 8-minute Blink, into a Blame Mail, into an Arm. Like, he needs so much.
If he's going to actually stand toe-to-toe with the heroes
right,
in LGD.
Right, right, right. Because you have things like Enfeeble.
Oh, Clockwork. I would give himself a hookshot. Now DDC. How much does he commit to this? There's Living Armor making sure the Junes can be protected. And there's no follow-up, so he holds on to his ulti while on top lane. AO will be the other gank hero. So Arrow's already connected. And the Storm Spirit makes sure he stays where he is while in flame on the bottom lane. He's going to go down. If the Timber Chain can latch, actually then Whirling Death, Hellfire Blast will come out. He managed to get the Chakram back off cooldown, but the Dream Call, he just TP's out. They have no other stun. Silence or not, they could not kill off Yao in such a situation.
Yeah, great decision to TP out, because even if he hooked to the tree, he would have probably died. What CIS hoped for is whether they could do enough damage so that when the coil breaks during the TP out, they could, you know...
Whoops. Fiend's Grip Brain Sap. Looks like Inflame just lost his ultimate.
Well, I mean, I guess that's okay. Because the ultimate has such a long cooldown, right? 260 seconds? You'll trade your Fiend's Grip for that.
The only downside now is Inflame's going to lose that little safety net that he feels.
Yeah, yeah.
To be standing up in this position when he is the only hero on that bottom lane, you only do that when you know you've got insurance.
I wonder what Lin's going for with this Glove of Haste. I hope it's really a Maelstrom, but, you know.
Oh, you may as well hope he's going to live through this. The arrow's flying out, and June's waiting for a hook shot, and he's in range for it now. Problem is, this Dire Creep
out.
Wave is such a problem.
He'll just leap out even if he gets hit by the hook. You need something to force the leap first, which they don't really have.
Well, unless they can make him burn his mana. But he's just got enough for a leap, Dire's so he's fine. Tower is under attack. There's finally the deep warding from LGD on the bottom lane. They know they're being watched. Zap. But Timbersaw's also got so much more space on this bottom lane too. He's still playing catch up. Like, Timbersaw's still sitting at 2.4k net worth. Black is the one. I still don't understand where this guy finds farm all the time. Like, he's got 3.9k net worth. He's beating this safe lane Mirana and has managed to pick up 11 minutes and 30 second blink dagger.
It's okay. Like, it's not too impressive considering that he didn't even upgrade his boots yet. So, it's a really rush blink, and he really needs to do a lot of this blink. Maybe pick off the Mirana once or twice.
They're coming for Timber. They smoked up on bottom lane. They're coming for the Timber.
Well, Timber is going to get some help, though, because Xiao Tuji or Rabbit is smoked up behind him. There's a Lich with the Chain Frost available. If they dump everything for the Timber Salt, they might kill him. But the return kill is going to be harmful.
Actually, I don't know if they can kill him. The Storm Spirit, actually, they go in first on Inflame. And the Hellfire Blast never comes out because he's already on the sidelines. Lich Ulti bouncing around Demons and Clockwork. They're a little bit too close at the moment. Sentry Ward for the Radiant side. trying to scatter the LGD. Hook shot up, but out of range of the Sentry Ward for now. Fiend's Grip over on top of June, and Rabbit jumps in for a hook shot. Try to get himself back out to safety, the Timbersaw. It's not enough, but it's enough for LGD. They do kill the Timbersaw, but they lose three heroes CIS in order to do such a thing.
And here's the thing, though. That was a 5v4 from LGD, because if you look at the Marana up top, Lin is still pushing away. Maybe he's still... It's like, hey man, I played a really nice Weaver game. I'm going to keep doing this, but as a Marana instead, you guys have fun fighting, and I'm going to just keep pressuring tower.
They're going to have a crack at DD. The jump in from Black with the silence. Lich is still here, but he's already lit off his Frost, doing a lot of DPS out of Black, and Black just orbs himself away. Actually, no, he didn't even jaunt himself. He phase shifted for a short time at the last moment. But the Bane will go down here on the bottom lane. But you're right, like, it's easy farm for a Marana on the top lane. It's actually a hand of Midas for him.
Oh, no.
So they just keep the farm going. While Storm Spirit, like, Rabbit was being involved in more kills. Like, he's got 5 assists and 1 kill, but he's managed to finish up at least his first Oblivion stuff.
The thing about this game is that he doesn't really need the Orchid to kill just about anybody else, apart from the Puck, right? Yeah. Like, he could just jump in against the AA, for example.
But the Puck's always the primary choice here for CIS. Wherever Black is, you make sure you kill him.
Yeah.
It's just that simple. If you kill off Black, CIS lose everything, because they always invest so much into him.
The other thing about the Storm play this game is that he is not trying to solo gank, which is something that Storm can do in other games, but against a Living Armor tree, it's a lot harder. You don't want to use half your mana, jump in, and we're like, oh, I can't get the skill. So he's actually mostly smoke ganking with his team, and I think that's the correct choice, because when these fights really break out, you want that Chain Frost to be next to you, aiding you. Obviously, you want the Timbersaw to tank for you, do that burst damage. Honestly, I think with the 2 core of a Marana with the Midas, the Stormster that's getting a lot of assists and levels, I think LGD is in a great spot. And CIS need to do something more with the Blink Dagger Puck. They need to do more with June. Yeah. Has June actually made any ganks?
Nope. He's tried. He's been watching that top lane for a long time. He attempted a hookshot on bottom lane once and it flew astray. There's been no successful movement from the clockwork, which for me is really, really surprising.
You safe lane this clock. You better get more out of him than what he's bringing to the table right now.
Yeah, but even then, they only semi safe laned him. Now he's looking at the Timbersaw, but he can't reach him. This is still only a level 1 hook. He just doesn't have the range available.
Yeah, I think right now LGD is just playing too well for these ganks to actually come out properly. Look at where Lin is. Look at where the 3 mid heroes. They know Clock's off the map. They're not messing around. You could argue that because Clock's missing off the map, LGD's farm is being slowed down as a result. That's definitely true. But they're definitely not dying.
I'm actually surprised that LGD don't have more observer wards across the map. Like, I know there's still one watch in the middle lane, because that's looking for the Clock gank there. And now I think they actually caught a glimpse of him. Yeah, they know where June is now. They saw him on the bottom lane. And then Lin is instantly back into that top lane. And Yao, well, with just the Chakram, he can actually hold this bottom lane out a hell of a lot.
They still have Glyph available, so this is definitely could go on for quite a bit. And you don't really want to tower dive, because tower diving without your creeps against a Chain Frost is a death sentence for yourself.
Yeah.
And you obviously, you have to deal with things like Moonlight Shadow, a Storm teleporting in, so... again, backing off.
And by doing so, like, they had 5 heroes in that bottom lane for a good 30 seconds to a minute.
Mm-hmm.
And Rabbit's been farming jungle. He's been rotating mid. He's now got his second point up in the ultimate. He's got a DD rune from the top river as well. And he's almost finished his second Oblivion stuff.
Yep.
And when this Orchid's up, like, Puck, the first time he revealed his Blink Dagger, they had a 3-for-1 trade in favor of LGD. When this first Orchid gets revealed, I hate to think what the trade's going to be for CIS.
Again, even with the Orchid, I think LGD, the Stormster will run with the rest of the team. It just makes their killing potential much stronger.
Yeah. Like, it makes the initiation. Like, if you remove Dream Coil and Silence from LGD, there's nothing else to really control or kill that Timbersaw. And that's the only reason why I'm putting such high value in the Orchid. Because I'm thinking Puck is the only major man who's going to be controlling that Timber.
I mean, another way to look at it is also speeds up your farm, because you could use your ball lining a lot more liberally, because... Well, the mono regen on the item is pretty legit, so I hope that Rabbit will do something with this DD, though, because Storm with the double damage essentially gives him the solo killing potential, even through Living Armor, but he's just kind of carefully farming it up in the jungle.
Just safety first, man. Yeah. Don't have to risk anything right now. LGD are one game ahead, and they know how far ahead in this game they are. Like, they know they're not being pressured. They know late game that they'll favor themselves because this clockwork has been next to, like, not effective at all. So you're like, okay, let's just play it safe.
Yep.
take no risk whatsoever, get the second game, and then it would be like a screw-up of monumental proportions if they're capable of losing the best of five after that point.
Well, NAR brought it back. Or actually, Liquid brought it to game five. So
that's true. Actually, a lot of the best of five grand finals recently have been taken to five. You look at the ESL 1, like the group stage playoff matches there. They were like 2-0 one way, and then, hey, best of five later, it was like 3-2.
Black got hit by arrow after using his face.
Oh.
But they're not going to go in for that.
No. I think they're more concerned about what CIS had behind them. But this is a big commitment from LGD. Like, they've got four or five heroes here on the bottom lane. Like, four heroes going to smoke up underneath the cover of their own sentry ward. Now, this is either, like, okay, the ping came to go for Inflame in middle lane. Because they don't have Orchid yet. They still don't have the Orchid yet. He's 600 gold short. But a long jump in. Actually, not even long jump. Now they're so close, it's just a short. Whoa, rabbit. Okay, that didn't look cool, right? Then another jump in. The Starfall and the arrow is still available. And they haven't killed Inflame yet. The arrow will come up and Inflame. Like, he still had Ankh through all of that engagement. That definitely wasn't the most flawless.
That was a mistake. We're going to just say how it is. That was a mistake from Rabbit. I mean, to be honest, even when they killed him as a secondary jump, at that point, Inflame would have been back under the safety of his own tier 1.
Oh, good arrow. June, that's a 5-second over on him. Storm Spirit's going to jump in. The Remnant should be able to get the kill, but Rabbit does another quick jump. They also burn through the Wraith King ultimate. Lich has already cast his own ultimate, however, but with a Fiend's Grip on the Wraith King, the Dream Court will break him free. Black might be saving his team right now. Two on the sideline, but DD's still standing his ground to fight. Storm Spirit back in again. But Bane's the man to take the kill on the Wraith King. Clockwork has brought himself back into this game, but he's walking out to the middle lane
because
his TP's on cooldown for another 20 seconds after he bought back.
That's RTZ buyback. It's like, whoops.
I thought I still had that.
Yeah.
I thought I could be a contender. If it wasn't for Black, though, CIS would have just lost three heroes for maybe one kill on LGD.
Yeah, I mean, that was a game of waiting, right? Like, Bane is waiting for the reincarn so he could grip for real, and then obviously the Puck is waiting for the Bane, and then you have Mirana waiting for this and that.
Yep.
But, I mean, sooner or later, when LGD is coming at you with his full force, with Tibbersaw leading the charge, with the Storm falling up, there's no more waiting. If you're Black, you need to jump in with a Coil, whether you like it or not. Also, Overgrowth as well as AA Ultimate, at this point, I don't think it's being able to keep up with the rest of how fast LGD is growing in terms of HP.
Yeah.
Again, the big problem with CIS's draft is that they don't have mid-game damage apart from that Puck. So I feel like these fights is going to get more and more lopsided as the game goes on.
Is June still looking for an opening here? Is he just waiting for the creep wave?
I think he's looking to play a different hero.
Wait, what?
I think Clogger is just not where he wants to be this game.
He's doing a re-pick halfway through the game?
Yeah.
That would be legit. It's the new, it's the $8 million unlock where you're able to change hero 20 minutes in, only available to those who have bought a compendium.
Who wouldn't buy a compendium?
If you could switch your hero halfway through the game.
Jesus Christ.
The abuse would be amazing.
But yeah, Clockwork this game, the only thing that he's really adding to the team is he does a very good job preventing those timber chains from going out. Because they change it now such that if you're mini stunned or stunned on a timber chain, the chain just stops. And obviously,
What?
I didn't see that on the bottom.
I wasn't even looking for that one. I was actually making sure that my Twitch chat was showing on my side. I didn't realize it wasn't.
Well, I think Storm just got stunned and died. And the fact that he didn't dodge a stun.
Wait, what? No, that should be enough to kill a Storm Spirit.
It was a tree and a Wraith King killing a Storm.
But that doesn't work either. Like, you don't have enough DPS unless Wraith King was critting on every single one and then also gave his crit over to demons.
I mean, if that happened in a pub game, you just give a question mark to your teammate.
Yeah.
Like, what is that? Like, you know?
Like, why feed?
Is that even possible?
I like how LGD try and defend this bottom tower. They're just like, Frost Armor up, boys. They can't regenerate it, so just Frost Armor up the towers.
They could deny it now, though.
They're going to lose their mid-tower. Arrow flies in. Oh, Black. That was a very last-minute dodge with his phase shift. But the tower's not going to go down yet. No, actually, they do have the nice. I suppose CIS, overall, they get the same amount of gold as one tower.
And they get a lot of map control, which is good. Especially for the team, right? For a Clockwork to actually get down the tier 1 towers, that's huge. You can now go in the jungle and find those supports. The problem is, LG is playing 5-man Dota, or at least holding hand Dota. They're not going to get picked apart. And here comes the Moonlight Shadow Gang on the bottom lane. A Fiend's Grip on Tree is all they need.
Well, Demons is hanging around long enough that they've got this. So, yep, Fiend's Grip it. Whirling Death with the Chakram and Demon. Look at his life points just go.
Cutting down them trees, man.
The Rockets are scouting out some Storm Illusions on this top lane. But that also means that June's in the neighborhood. And this is scouting arrow from LGD flies as well. Radiant's bottom tower. Everyone's looking for an opening. Black wants to go in deep. Now he's got this Yule Scepter up and running. Probably feels like he's going to be great. And he actually found a hero. Lin, the Aeoldi will actually put like the Chilling Touch onto him. He's going to blink up and go for this though, but he doesn't have any vision here. So he blinks up, he throws the orb out. The Rocket came a little bit late, but he did find DDC straight away. So Black doesn't jaunt in to follow.
Yeah, obviously the Yule's choice for Black is to protect himself against the Orchid. If you're silenced and yourself up in the air, you come back. And you know, obviously it works really well with Blink Dagger and things like Phase. And Mono Regen is you know, not irrelevant.
The chat's screaming and saying they were invis. But even then, that shouldn't be enough to catch out the Stolen Spirit boys.
Well, maybe if they're really like on top of him. Because the ball lightning does have a startup wind time. So I guess that makes sense. Mm. But yeah, is the question to you, Toby, is Inflame Farming enough to carry his team?
Is Inflame Farming enough?
Yes.
I'm going to sit on the edge of this. I'm sitting on the edge of this because he still found a lot of experience. And because he is pulling in the DPS, like he doesn't have his big damage healing item from the crypt, but that's where his armlet comes in. It gives him his early game team fight. He's got the initiation required. He still needs, obviously, some bigger items to follow up. But for now, I think it's enough that he can fight up. But it still puts a lot more pressure on Black to do his job. Together, they can win. Separate, they can't do shite. And Clockwork, well, so far, we're still... Like, I know we've been kind of a little bit harsh on June, but... There's still no presence from him.
No.
Like, normally you're fearful. Like, we saw it, LGD. They clock's missing on the map. They back up to the tier 1 towers. Now they have a crack at Yao. There's your crit coming out. With the Timber Chain away, Inflame actually follows him up here. Yao will go down, but the Leech Seed's over on, it was on Yao, giving Inflame a little bit more life points, but Storm Spirit's taking out the tree, and now Inflame ulti. The Orchid is on cooldown for now. There's more support coming in. Black's on his way in, but Fiend's Grip's off cooldown for DD. They hide inside the Moonlight Shadow. Black very wisely does not jaunt into that. But it comes to one-for-one trade. And maybe that's where we see, like, just how they can dish out that DPS. Like, you get the initial hit, and then you follow up with a Blink Dagger. You can keep that DPS flying. So with a short jump, it's not enough.
Mm-hmm. I really like the choice of him just...
Black. Very deep. They're coming in for DD. The Lich holding, but it's only the two of them here. The phase shift is going to keep this bouncing. However, Black, Yule Scepter's himself up, but the Orcus on the Wraith King, and he's got no ultimate to save him from this, but Rabbit's got no mana. The Dream Call and the Arrow, it actually ends up falling a little bit too short. And three heroes lost for LGD, and a Timber Chain, Chakram, Whirling Death. There goes one. They wait for Black to come back up into the world of the living. The living armor will protect him as June TP's out, man of influence. Yes. And he dies to the Chakram straight away. That timing with Tim sort of get the kill.
Yeah, I mean, if he actually survived that particular, if he was able to phase correctly in that particular engagement, he would have Yule Scepter back up. And that, you know, who knew that Goose Chase would have went for that one. But it's still a fairly good engagement. Unfortunately, they lost Wraith King. And Mirana was able to pick up every single kill, or at least the experience for that kill.
And Timbersaw was able to get enough money for his Bloodstone too.
I mean, at this point, Mirana, she's already being able to... once she gets the next damage item, Maelstrom, Daedalus, whatever, like she's already a big damage source. At this point, Timbersaw is almost unkillable with this Bloodstone picked up. CIS men, are they progressing quickly enough?
With the death of Wraith King now, I kind of want to sit on the edge of no, because we're not going to see the like straight into the next big item for Wraith King.
Yeah,
and because of that is where my major concern is. Unless June steps up to the plate right now and is able to find some really good hook shots in, but even then, like when he jumps in, he can't kill Storm, he can't kill Mirana, and he can't even kill Timbersaw. Really, like he can't kill off any of these three cores or control these three cores at all. So all it really is just a hook shot into Cogs. That's all he really provides.
So, I was looking, maybe they could kill like a Lich, but no.
See, even the Lich is really difficult to kill off because you try and go for him, he's going to force stuff. He's going to jump, push himself straight out of the cogs. And the same kind of thing for any other hero that gets caught in that. And you can't kill off a Bane.
Yeah.
Bane just has to survive long enough to get a Brain Sap off. And then he's back up enough life points where he'll probably feel confident enough to throw out his Fiend's Grip. So you can't kill him that way either. And with the Ogre Club already on him, building into a BKB, it's very, very difficult to do anything against him. What I find actually, like, not hilarious, but interesting, is the fact that LGD, through all of this, they still refuse to go mech. That's like they don't feel they need it on their lineup. I thought Lich would have done that, actually.
Mechs for cowards. Actually, I like the Force Staff a little bit better. I think mech, obviously, a little bit better for the team, but it seems like the way their LG is playing is just, you know, we're just going to farm. Is under attack. Defend our towers here and there, but we're going to just really look to farm. And it surprises me that LGD is playing this passively. They are looking for kills whenever they can. They are defending towers and fighting under the towers, but they're not the one that's, hey, let's push that tier 1 mid, for example.
Is it key items they're waiting for? Maybe they're waiting for the BKB to be finished over on Rabbit.
Or maybe they just feel that they have the, you know, much superior late game, and there's just no need to take any risk.
That could be it, but if they start getting picked off, then CIS could start to snowball in, because CIS, you still got to look at and say CIS have the tower advantage to a point, because the creep waves are pretty damn close. Like, they're normally over the line in favor of CIS here. Mm-hmm. And that's one thing CIS has been doing time and time again. They might be able to get themselves a killer on DDC, hookshot in, and then Black with the tree fist bump brings him down. That's because the Lich DDC.
Nice kill.
But LGD, like, the map control still isn't that amazing for them. Like, for everything they've got, their team fight's still really, really good. But CIS, with the Ankh now off cooldown for Inflame, they're ready just to force down these towers, get a little bit more map control, and back LGD into a corner. Force LGD to come out and try and fight them before they're like, yeah, we have more farm than any of you. You can't do anything. There's Mech now over on Tree and Protector. CIS is, like, their stability is really still damn good. And here's Inflame finding his item. And I kind of like this one too. Desolator pickup.
Need damage.
Yep. And
need a lot of damage.
It's not just the damage too. If he survives through the fight, they can start ripping through buildings quite quickly. And that's what I want to see from him. Because CIS just can't accept the fact that winning a fight will win you the game. Because it won't. They've got to win a fight and take a map control position every single time.
I mean, I completely agree with this item choice on Rave King, but the other way I'm looking at the situation for him picking up Deso is that the Deso essentially is just countering a Frost Armor as well as an Enfeeble from the two supports.
Hmm.
That's actually what he's just doing, right? The damage you're getting from the Mithril Hammer, Enfeeble takes that away. The minus armor that you gain is Lich being granted back. So yeah, like, he's getting a great item, but these supports are just killing the Wraith King. Like, you can't really do anything against his supports.
So you would prefer to see something like a BKB?
No, I'm saying he has to get it just to counteract it. It's still the best item I think he could get with that gold. It's just like, I'm saying he's in a shitty situation.
Yeah. So basically, you need to be able to pick up two items for the price of one.
Essentially, yeah.
Right. Well, unfortunately, that doesn't happen here in Dota.
There's no buy two, get one free special on the shopkeeper.
See, that would be amazing, man. $9.99 at your local Dota 2 store.
There you go.
And if you're not satisfied with your purchase, you can get your money back.
Half of it. Unless you sell it instantly. Then you only get unreliable world back.
You can go back into a repayment plan. So like you get half of it back straight away, and then over time, you'll get the other part of it back.
That'll be broken.
But only when you purchase new items. Because obviously, you've got to keep your customers, man. You've got to keep them coming back to your store. Imagine if they change that.
I think the Dota store has a monopoly over heroes. There is one store. You buy it, whether you like it or not.
So what you're saying is Valve doesn't have to try to keep their customers happy because everyone has to come to them anyway?
Yes.
I see.
They got economists working on this shit.
Mm.
They know.
That's how Gabe started the Empire.
Okay, real fast, real talk.
Yep.
Not really impressed with Lin's farm. Because earlier we were saying that, you know, he's solo playing the game.
He's not joining the fight, right?
Like, he's just split pushing by himself.
Yeah.
If you look at the net worth, he's like 1,000 go ahead of Puck.
Yeah.
Now, granted, this is Black's Puck. You know, different breed of Puck.
Yeah, where's all of his money going?
Yeah, you have a hand of Midas on Mirana.
He should have more than this, really, for 31 minutes in. Storm Spirit is just scouting out the fact that Inflame is in here. I'm not sure about this at all. Like, the Orchid's over on the Wraith King. It's going to be a lot of burst damage coming off the back of that. In fact, it does trigger off his ulti. And Storm Spirit just goes into his BKB.
What?
I don't know why he's doing that, because there's no follow-up here from CIS at all.
So
the question is, does CISS have enough balls to go in and say, you know what, we're down reincarnation, we're going to go in anyway?
No. No.
Okay.
I almost feel like, and I think that's the reason why the BKB popped up from Rabbit, that like it had to be a bait. Like, LGD would have got there and go, wait, why is Wraith King the only one inside the pit? It has to be a trap. Sure. Like, Clockwork has to be trying to hook himself in and split the team.
The thing is, for everything that CIS could do to you, like Overgrowth or a Waning Rift, you could BKB out of that. There's not anything dangerous to say that if you're hexed, you're dead. Like a lion in a game.
Yeah, true.
So I just don't think that BKB is necessary.
Could have been a slip of the finger. Yeah. Try to bottle charge, hit the BKB instead.
Sure, fair
Try
enough.
To tread switch, hit the BKB instead. He wasn't orchiding because he already did the orchid. So, could have just been a finger slip. Either way, 18 to 15 on the board. We've had ourselves some, like, I think the skinheads are now in our house right now. I've got to be a little bit jelly. Like, our fight's at least been nice back and forth. LGD still definitely have a lot of control of this game. Like, you just look at the experience itself. Like, if you actually ignore the gold and look at the experience I'll own, mm-hmm. like, LGD are 8,000, 8.5K in front. The gold actually tells a very different story. Because it's only like 2.75,
right?
In favor of LGD, and then they did have like a 5K advantage. But of course, again, LGD still haven't taken two tier one towers in this game. They're still missing any form of map control. That's what I'm like. CIS
that's
is keeping
fine, though.
Is keeping LGD on their side of the map the entire time.
Yeah, you could say that CIS playing really well, and I agree. That's definitely the case. But should CIS slips up and lose one fight? That all these tier one towers, it's just free gold. I do want to say that this is why I really dislike experience graph or gold graph. Like, it's a very good way to quickly look, this is where we're at.
Yeah.
But let's hold F7 and press E on your keyboard, Toby. I think this is really explain why LGD is ahead in the gold graph, but not really ahead. The reason they're 75,000 ahead on experience is because Lich and Bane
have nothing. Oh,
they have a lot higher than the other supports.
Yeah.
But if you look at the rest of it, it's like pretty even. So I think it comes back to the early game. I think when you said Bane is like 3-2. Mm-hmm. So he got a lot of experience and he was able to ramp up.
It'd actually be kind of nice if we can see like the experience earned and then just see each of the heroes.
Sure.
Yeah. Actually individually. Ice Rogue, please make.
Or maybe like compare the roles, like one role to one role.
Yeah.
Two role to two role. I think that's how League of Legends does it. They have like the CS lined up against the core. But obviously in League of Legends,
the roles are a lot more defined in
League of
Legends.
They're more locked. You know, you never have like Black playing mid. For example, as true. Black's one for the team, right? But he's playing mid two games in a row
true.
Now.
And like in this game too, you could say like Clockwork was your safe laner at the very, very start with number three position Wraith King, and then they switched it up to 8 minutes.
So
it's very difficult to compare those kind of roles.
Yeah.
But it'd be just nice to break down each individual hero to see how all that kind of stuff happened. That is actually one thing I missed from the Warcraft 3 days, man. Remember like the end stat screen, like or the stat screen you could bring up at any point of the game, covered your entire screen.
But it gave you everything that you possibly wanted and more.
It's like if I want to find out how many times Puck has killed the Bane and Bane has killed the Puck, I would have those answers for me.
Yep.
How many towers do they kill straight away? How many towers denied? How much gold was spent? How many wards were purchased? Oh! I would love all this information in real time again. I actually requested that a year and a half ago.
Somebody actually said that should be a companion stretch goal.
Yeah, well, actually, what, caster tools?
No. Just like once the game is completely over, you have all of that.
It would be
like
nice.
Like a regular pub game once that's over. But obviously, if you're going to do that for a regular pub game, you might as well just, hey, you know, do it for a pro game as well.
Yeah. Then again, people are like, oh, but you just pull it with an API. I'm like, yeah, but like, here in the game, I'm not a massive fan. Like, that's the reason why it's like, if you ever make overlay tools and shit like that, like the Rubik's steal ability, it's like, well, you can pull it and take the time to do it all in real time, or you could just put it inside the game. Because I don't want the Dota TV people to have something less than what the stream people have.
I mean, that's exactly what Dota 2's been doing, right? Like, if a stream has a good idea, Valve just steals it.
Yeah. Well, actually, technically, Valve had that idea before. They just took Valve time to create it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well then.
I can reference an email from a year and a half ago for that one.
Oh, so this one only took a year and a half.
Yeah.
Great. By the way, we have Techie soon.
Yeah.
Soon.
Soon. After TI4. Man, you know what I said to you about that one. Free to play was meant to come out after TI3. Yeah. See how long that one took, huh? Well, middle lane push is coming out from CS as we're back here inside the game. Uh-oh. Blinking already from Inflame, going right in on top of Yao. And Yao, the Aeoli will be off target, and actually Yule sector him up in towards the air as well. Now, DDC is still holding on to his Frost Blast, and Arrow only just skims out, missing on almost everybody. But Lin is still coming in from the rear,
Lin's gonna
and they're
hexed.
Coming high ground. Well, they try, but he actually dodged it. The mana started to dodge the Inflame's Hellfire Blast. Now, Inflame's going to drop here. He's still got 60 seconds left when he comes back up again, but that's not going to be long enough to get his ulti back off cooldown again, and that's Inflame. Let's look at the death. There is, however, the Chilling Touch. Lich ulti will be taken off to the side by Demons. It's only one on the sideline, but they've got him twice. Now Rhyme will join them with Clockwork as well as Puck teaming up together. They're after AO. The Brain Sap coming off cooldown. Living Armor will protect him for a little bit, but not long enough. He was trying to bring down DDC, not enough, and now, well, where's Fiend's Grip? He doesn't have mana. Actually, he does. There's 15 one charges up the sleeve here of DDC. But they've got to get him in range. Four staffing Yao in closer. There's your Fiend's Grip. They bring down Black, and Clockwork is too far away to help, and Terrain Protector is back at base.
Yeah, that was a really poor team fight that CIS took. And note the, you know, the lack of coordination when you yield somebody from an Ice Blast, things like that. What CIS really need is a quick pickoff and then extend that team fight. And when you blink in with Wraith King, when you miss your Ice Blast, I think that's a signal to get out. Unfortunately, it's really hard to run away from a Timbersaw and Storm. So essentially, CIS just has one chance to go, they have one chance to do it properly, or they're done.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a very difficult lineup to play against from an LGD side.
Ooh, June, he's gone in with the AA ulti. Roshan, he's so low on life, the Sharkam's still killing him off.
Pick it up!
Darnie's Vegas! Outside the pit, but Yao is not a happy chappy. He's coming in for some revenge, and so is Rabbit. Orchid's over on Demons. There's no control from him. They move over towards Inflame. Hey, his ulti's off cooldown at least, but it's back onto cooldown again now with the SK Wraith King ulti triggering off. He comes back to life again. Blink Dagger off cooldown in 1 second time, but Moonlight Shadow is protecting LGD for now, but not enough with the Sentry Ward down. They forced off Yao a little bit deeper in, and CIS can't get any kind of follow-up to this.
Well, they stole the Aegis. That is a pretty big play that June has made. We've been saying that he hasn't made
like,
hey,
play. June, you've done like, where is your help? Where is your like your purpose in the game? Mm-hmm. That's his purpose.
Well, I mean, the thing is, Aegis on clock is not exactly too helpful though.
At least it's better than denying the Aegis on a Storm Spirit.
Yeah, that's actually the true play. Storm doesn't have the Aegis. Lin is just walking straight in, hits the arrow on June, but he gets hexed, and actually June is still alive. Meanwhile, Lin forced a leap away. The Chain Frost is actually going to take care of the Clockwork. No, Clockwork's actually still alive. Ice Blast coming in. AO is going to go down to the Chakram, not magic. And that is going to be it, I believe.
Nope. Jump long, and that's actually the Aegis Immortal gone. Okay. There's no follow-up to kill him off, but hey, they get rid of the Aegis at least.
Demons will spot out Yao here. Oh, Yao's got 17 Bloodstone charges. Mm-hmm. Jesus Christ.
He hasn't died much, dude. And when he does, he'll be straight back up again. I'm also a little bit concerned about Demons hiding here in the tree line. Especially all the arrow from Lin. That was a scout arrow. That's all that was.
No, was it?
They have a
Rabbit
gem.
Rabbit have a gem. Yeah,
they have a gem. Okay, so he moved up. Yeah. I was like, if that was actually just a legendary scout arrow, that would be awesome, but there's a gem.
And this is what I mean. They win one fight, and they're going down hard. There's a tier 1 tower. The only reason they're not going for tier 2 is because their own tier 2 top is being pressured, so they'll go back and farm that. There's no rush. No rush. Mirana picks up a Death Soul for that mid-game deeps. And probably going to go into probably a Butterfly or maybe a Maelstrom after that. Mm-hmm. Anything's good. Just get deeps.
I've not enough money to do it. 7.5k for LGD. The experience is now actually 17k, man. If you want to look at the hero levels this time around, Clockwork now joins the bottom three. So 13, 11, and 10 to the 14, 15, 16, 17, which is the LGD bottoms.
Not looking good, man. Supports are out-leveling the cores.
Yep. That's a problem right there. Rabbit. What's he going to pick up? A new TP scroll? Still with that 3.1k. I'm wondering if LGD are finally going to take the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. It's kind of like a stain on the map for their reputation right now. 37 minutes in, and it's still not gone. Like, Mirana has still very little.
Yeah, considering that she's been free farming.
Yep.
She has less CS than the Puck and the Storm, who has been actively fighting. Obviously, a lot of that were neutral, so you know it's not exactly fair to compare it like that. But
5-man smart gank coming out from LGD. They're coming to mid, and they're going to find Inflame. But then again, he's on the high ground here, so the smoke. Actually, they use the Moonlight Shadow as well, and they're going to look for some openings here. And who do they go on? The Orchid Hello and goodbye to the Agenap Rushan. Deeply into June 2, and they're just so far in. The Fiend's Grip, okay, I don't know why that was cast. He was going absolutely nowhere. But 2 euros down for CIS.
I really like the fact that they saw Inflame on the Wraith King, and they're like, you know what? We're not going to go for this target. We're going to go for the lot more vulnerable targets, because all the previous sites, they just blow everything on the Wraith King. And it's like, oh, we have to kill him again.
It's like 60 seconds is all he needs. So yeah. Once he dies, he's back up again with his ultimate.
They might kill him now.
If DD can... actually, he doesn't have a 4 stuff because he built a Ghost Scepter. There's also more help around here. So we Ghost Scepter to start with. The Hellfire Blast will be there, but Storm Spirit is one jump in and Wraith King TP's out inside the tree line. But unfortunately... where was the Tree Protector? He got out to safety too. Yep. They both TP'd out, but by doing so, they forfeit their tier 1 tower.
And perhaps a little bit more. If you look at the wave on top and mid, it's fairly pushed. So I think LGD has enough time to actually start pressuring the tier 2. But if you want to push the tower, you better be damn sure you get it, because the Treant's going to heal it back up if you don't.
Man, look, you actually see the DPS against the towers. They've got more than enough. And they're ready to commit too. Okay, they pipe just goes to AA, but like that BKB is still there on Rabbit. I know it's down to a 6-second BKB, but that's more than enough just to jump in and cause chaos.
Yeah.
And once the BKB's finished on DD, Tree is the only one that can say... Actually, that's not true. Clockwork as well.
I mean, 4-second BKB on Storm doesn't really mean anything, because you could just get out when that BKB is done, if you want to get out.
Yeah. You just pop it when the initial blast comes, or you do it like what Mirana did. Like, you pop Mana Style to avoid the Hellfire Blast.
Which, by the way, is pretty sexy.
Yeah. And Lin's actually going to finish his BKB now. Does this make you feel a little bit more comfortable about him?
Yeah, that's okay.
For 40 minutes in?
No.
Yeah, no quarter. No mercy from Lumi.
Not impressed. Maybe he's just...
demons. If he sees his courier...
He can kill the courier.
The Observer will see it. Yeah, he just turns. It's like, okay. Punch. BKB, and it's actually got the Sheevan's Guard. And
punch
the leap in. Oh, it actually delivered. It delivered the BKB, but Lin, he's already used leap. He'll trigger the BKB straight away. I would have gone for the courier then, man. That thing had so much on it.
The problem is Treen attacks so slowly that his base damage at this point can't actually kill the courier in one shot. He needed 2 shots. He needed to hit it once, and then the courier delivered item, and then it's way back. He had to hit again.
Oh. I don't know if that would have been enough damage, though. It's a level 2. Actually, with the rocket,
yeah,
it would have been.
Enough, yeah.
Just a fraction too early. DDC! Oh, man. Good thing that Moonlight Shadow kicked in. One hit, one crit from the Wraith King, and DDC lost what looked to be 80% of his life points.
Okay, I think we are getting close to a stage where Inflame will start to become too dangerous. Like, if he gets a heart, and maybe another item on top of the heart...
I'd actually just look for the Assault Cuirass out of this guy, man. Would you want to do that or just go straight for DPS?
I think he has enough. I mean, look at the crits.
But at the same time, man, these fights aren't lasting long enough for CIS for him to say, I can just tank up and get through it. Because that's what his ulti's going to do. He just tries to soak up as much as he can, then come back up again and one-hit someone.
Right.
So even Mjolnir may actually be a better choice for him in this.
Well, actually, the items that we initially suggested, Heart and AC, like, both of them increases survivability. Both of them add to the damage.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like not too bad either way. Whereas the Mjolnir is just nothing but damage.
Yep.
So we'll see how he feels about the game. 2k gold in the bank. The problem with Wraith King at this point in the game is he just farms so slowly. Slow attack speed. Hitting creeps one at a time.
Mm-hmm. He needs something more. Because when I look at the items from LGD, like when you got a Shiva's Guard done with a Bloodstone, which now is up to 20 charges over on Yao, yep. And then you're still going up against Mirana, who is very elusive with a Mana Style. Even Bane with Ghost Scepter makes it very difficult. Lich is about to finish a mech. He's 400 or so gold away from doing so. And Storm Spirit built BKB Lincoln Sphere Orchid. Like, Rabbit's building himself to be the guy in the front lines that cannot be controlled.
Mm-hmm.
We also have potential Roshan spawn time in 5 seconds.
We see it.
So LGD may just wait for this one. It's going to be difficult to keep, like, to actually fully take Roshan, though. When you got Rocket Scouting as well as Ancient Apparition Ultimates, it's always going to be noted. And we, okay, so it looks like we got a Roshan spawn time roughly 2 minutes.
Black, meanwhile, looks like he's looking for a Lincoln Sphere himself.
Whoops.
Priest Toby.
My bad.
And professional.
Hey, it's Swedish keyboard, man. There's buttons where they shouldn't be.
That's true. I hate Swedish keyboards. Like, it took me forever to find, like, hashtag sign. And it's, I know it's Shift-3, but Shift-3 doesn't give me hashtag, not on a Swedish keyboard.
You should try it with this one. You actually can't use the 3 button on this.
Yeah, because you bind it to XSplit.
No, it's just because the 3 button doesn't work on this keyboard.
Oh, great.
No other reason, man. Oh, yeah. That's the reason why I have English keyboards in our studio in Germany. I can't use the German ones anymore. They're more frustrating. Oh, Roshan, 1 minute 20 seconds. If LGD just wait this out, they pick up Roshan. Like, they've still got tier 2 towers to get through, though. But I think for them, it's all about just the next fight. Can they keep the fight momentum going? With the Timbersaw, it's really not that hard as well. Mm-hmm. Like, if Timbersaw's the first one into the front lines, he has no problem sacrificing himself in the early stages. Because by doing so, the rest of LGD are basically going back up to, I won't say full life, but pretty damn close to it.
Like a Big Mac.
Yeah. I will supersize our fight.
So Wraith King's going for BKB. So is Clockwork. I'm not sure how I feel about this. I think BKB, if you get 144 minutes in the game, sure, you're going to have a majority of your charges at 10 seconds, which is, you know, or max seconds, which is great. At the same time, though, LGD is so mobile, they could just jump away or leap away. And then you have Fiend's Grip, who could control you through your BKB.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sure with this choice either, man.
Like, I'm not saying it's bad, it's just...
It's just one of those avenues you take where you're like, I need to go defensive. I kind of still want to be able to fight during the engage. So maybe he's just getting really frustrated by the fact that he keeps getting controlled by other abilities.
I'm like, just saying, man, Lich and Bane are just like, they wreck carry, melee carry so hard.
Mm-hmm. Roshan's up. Now the Rocket scout this one. Yao comes in just enough time to see the fact the Rocket was there. So both LG and CIS know that each other know about Roshan. But Inflame's being sent towards the front lines, and this is how they keep him up. They trigger the Lincolns over on the Wraith King. But then if you're doing that, you don't need the BKB.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, right?
It's
he has 2 lives and Lincoln's charge.
I almost want like don't give it, Black. Hold on to the Lincolns yourself.
Meanwhile, another BKB is a little bit more impressive, the one on Bane. Because that means Dreamcore no longer brings him out. You now only have Overgrowth and Clockwork Hook.
Yep.
There we go.
And Clockwork's been evaporating at the start of the fight anyway, and especially like Tree Protect is the same kind of thing. Because Timbersaw loves both these heroes, and with the Moonlight Shadow movement, they're going to try and come in, and hello June, and hello demons. Dust to pop, just to make sure they can keep seeing him. Clockwork actually got the hookshot in, but he's locked in here with three heroes. They jump back out again, and June, the Desolate attacks just keep following him, as well as the Storm Spirit. Their chase potential is huge. The gem was dropped, it was on a courier that was coming up the middle lane. The whole shebang is dying right now. CIS, they've lost 3 heroes, courier and gem. Black is about to jump back in again because Inflame is in the middle of the LGD lineup. He's triggered his BKB, the Ankh will go, and the 4-man Dream Call, it just means they wait longer to kill off Inflame, which is now. The arrow from Lin was perfectly positioned. Black is back down the middle lane. The LGD just had the flawless fight in the middle lane.
Yeah, it was great pickoffs one after another. The smoke, the better initiation coming out from the Storm Spirit. And they really wanted that mech to last them the team fight. Again, it's CIS, they have to initiate. They have to get a couple kills to start the fight. They didn't do that, and LGD, they rolled them down. And I think I will retake back the flames I gave to Lin, because this build is actually really good for tower pushing.
He jumps in. Oh, we phase shift to point blank. The AOD will hit, and Tree comes in throwing his overgrowth. No. But Black is being dragged back in again. The Lich ulti has also been triggered. Yule Scepter up into the air will protect him for now, while Demon's just trying to run away from Lin. And Black, he dies. He dies on the front lines. They'll lose melee racks with Black on the sideline. There's no control. There's no Wraith King up. He cannot buy back into this game. The only upside for CIS is their tier 2 towers are still up on the off lanes. So LGD will either go for a GG push and run the risk of losing maybe one or two heroes, or they back up and they just play it safe. And it looks like we'll take option number two.
I'm surprised they didn't just run back for Roshan. But they are defending a lot of creeps in front of the towers. Still get it back later.
Dagon's building Timber, man. This guy's got 26 Bloodstone charges. I don't understand how like someone could just not die during the fights like Yao's been doing.
I mean, CIS, again, where's the damage?
True.
No damage.
And in flame, like... It's also one of those, gets off with the question, if I can live through the engagement, what does it actually do me? Like, I live through the entire thing as a Wraith King, but I have no other teammates with me.
No, it actually is not about Wraith King living through. It's about his teammates living, which, you know.
Oh, which means that Wraith King's got to be there to make sure they do live, yeah, and the only way to do that is kill LGD faster. Which is why, like, BKB doesn't really assist him in such a thing. And you can see his intention for it. Like, he triggered the BKB before his ulti went. So he's like, my ulti is just a backup for maybe me to get like one extra kill before I really kick the bucket. But now Roshan's going to be in the hands of LGD. That's a level 3 Dagon from Timbersaw.
Soon to be 5.
It won't take long, man. Especially when Inflame's running out this far. Like, he blinked himself away, but there's no way he knows what vision LGD have. And look at Lin too. Full butterfly completed over on him. He sells the Midas and he can basically 6 slot.
Yeah, that's so mid game choice actually very good because this is the point where when you win a fight, you push towers. And this push much better than Emil Nair does, tower wise.
Yep.
So obviously, they're not short of any creep clearing abilities. And Lin is just chomping down towers.
What, just. Oh, Yao would be the man to do that. Aeol is coming to that bottom lane, but it's going to have no effect. They can just group up, trigger off the pipe. Who gives a crap? I think they're fine. The tier 2 tower is already gone. In fact, they're not even going to do it. Because they could just tank up through all of this. The mech will go first. And now they'll breach higher ground. So looking for the secondary racks. Living Arm is trying to protect this tower from the initial onslaught.
They have a Hex available now in Storm 2, so the pickoff on Puck is quite real.
Well, there's your jump in. Going in on first, the Ancient Apparition. He'll trigger off from the Orchid. Now Black, he can't control because the BKB went off from Rabbit in time. June, actually a really good hookshot in to the body block. Inflames in the back lines here. They've already managed to kill off the Bane, but now the Lich Ulti is going to bounce back up. Kills off Inflame. He'll respawn back up again quickly. The Mirana is still alive inside the base, being Yule-scepted up. And Lin just turns his damage over towards Inflame until he got turned into a Piglet. Forced after way. And Inflame, he's looking for a crit. Gets one. And the Hellfire Blast will take the kill. But he's on the sidelines. Black is back inside the base healing up. But the damage is still being done. The point that LGD is at right now, they got so much money, experience, gold, anything advantage over CIS. All they got to do is just throw their corpses to kill off these Raxes.
Yeah, and Inflame's coming in, trying to get that kill on, again.
How are you supposed to? And why would it even matter if you do?
28 Bloodstone charges.
Yep. He'll instantly respawn.
Yep.
Almost twice over, actually.
No, don't you lose like half of your charges when you die? Is it half or is it like...
I don't think it's actually a full half, man.
Loses a third. Mm. So he'll respawn back with like... close to 10 charges? Or close to 20 charges? Yeah, he actually can't respawn like close to twice. Oh. Maybe the second one he'll have to wait like, you know, 5 seconds.
Storm Spirit just hit himself another kill on mid. Managed to find the Ancient Apparition. Downside of the Storm with his 40 mana regeneration per second, that's still not enough.
He actually is not, yep.
He has to wait it out a little bit longer. But he's got 3.1k gold, maybe after. What else would you buy on this? Actually, he could buy his own Bloodstone.
At this point for Storm?
Yeah. Like, what else would you get? Like, what would you replace the Aegis Immortal with for the Storm Spirit?
I'll go for bots first before. Obviously, if he gets a lot of gold first. But once Aegis runs out. Yeah, Bloodstone's not bad.
I'm just thinking about, like, what would give you the regeneration you're searching for. You could try and just go for Heart. But at this point, your mana regeneration is your key thing. You could try and get a Shiva's, that'll like, give you some stability as well as a bit more of a mana pool.
Maybe you go like Mjolnir and be the real Lightning Lord.
Really?
Yeah. No, I'm just joking.
It's like, I want to see Titan to pick up Mjolnir at one point. Now, Inflame, that stun's not going to work against Lincoln Spear. Dagon, and then Riptide it down. But support is here, but June, he doesn't have a clear line for a hook, and then Fiend Grip on the Wraith King, he's down again already. The Lich Aldi, CIS walk themselves into the bouncers, and June is locked here. The Pipe's already triggered, the Mech as well, LGD, they've taken minimal damage, and the GG is called. 53 minutes in, it took a lot longer than it really probably needed to, but either way, LGD is now 2 games up over CIS here in the grand final. CIS have a very long road if they want to come back here in the best of 5. It was already a tough ask for them to win up against LGD, but right now they're not looking too healthy on the run.
I'm just surprised by the fact that CIS 2 games in a row just played a style that was not really suited to your playstyle. They put Black Mid twice. Where's my anti-mage carry?
Yeah.
Where's my PLs?
But this is also like CIS had to have gotten to the point. We talked about this too. Like LGD are going to come in and go, well, you could take it late game. We're fine with this.
Yeah.
We know we can battle you against late game. So why should we even bother like changing our style? Because we know we can beat you in your current one.
Yep.
So CIS are trying something new. Didn't work though.
2 games in a row didn't work.
No. Game 3, we'll find out. Stay tuned. We'll be back.